he may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke your name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When 8 days were completed for his circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
This is actually the eighth day of the Christmas octave. I know the world has forgotten about it. People tend to restrict Christmas to one day, but it's actually a season. It's because we must savor and continue to celebrate the mystery of Jesus. He's really the reason for the whole thing. Now, on the eighth day, what happened was he was given his name, he was circumcised, and this is a commemorated day. In fact, today's commemoration at one time was known as the Feast of the Circumcision, and at other times, the Feast of the Holy Name. Now it's called Mother of God, meaning recognize the motherhood of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Now, why are these things important? One of the reasons is because they tell us that Jesus is real. He was a real person who came into human history. We know his name, know that he was Jewish, know that he had a mother, he still has a mother. But because it's a perennial temptation among some people to try to explain away Jesus as being either some kind of a fiction or to change him into their own, according to their own conception. So, for example, the idea that Jesus wasn't real, you can't say that. Some people think it's just an idea that never really existed. Hitler claimed that Jesus was part of the Aryan race. Well, he wasn't. He was Jewish. And we know that he was circumcised. Then there's a church in San Francisco. It's not a Catholic church, but there's actually a woman on the cross. Jesus wasn't a woman. But the point of the story is we have to avoid the temptation to reinvent Jesus. It's not a good idea. And there's a movie out, and this is not the first movie to this effect. If you subscribe to the particular entertainment vehicle, I would ask you to have a second thought about doing that. But basically, it's the story of Jesus who's living an immoral lifestyle. Well, that's ridiculous. We just can't accept things like that. Jesus was sinless, and Jesus, according to another producer, this was on a number of years ago, public television, oh, we discovered Jesus' family tomb. He wasn't married, he was celibate. So you see this tendency to try to change him, to remake him into whatever image we want to make him into. That's the devil behind that. Jesus is real, you know his name, you know his mother, you know who he was, who he is. And then he's not just a mere man. Any mere man, a woman has a mother, which is fine, and that's important to know. But we call Mary the Mother of God because Jesus is God. He's not just a human, he is. So this takes care of people who would claim, well, Jesus is nothing particularly special. If we want to follow him, fine, we don't have to. I remember speaking with a fellow from the parish, and oh no, he's interested in the Buddha. Well, the Buddha's not God. He didn't claim to be. I would rather follow the God-man, the one savior of the world, than somebody else who has no real authority to pretend that he's the answer to what we need. So we have to keep things straight and be careful about the entertainment world and the world in general that tends to want to pull down our faith. This is why we come to church, pray, and so forth. Now, we know that we're headed into a new year. I would ask people to consider making resolutions that include spiritual life. So, for example, praying the rosary on a daily basis. If the person isn't already doing it. Or even coming to an extra mass, maybe one during the week, the person isn't doing it. It's something to think about. Going to confession every couple of months, if the person isn't doing it. In other words, there are so many things we can do to have a better year spiritually, help increase our faith, maybe read a good spiritual book or something along these lines. Take advantage of maybe a parish program that we're offering. We have a few things in mind. Look at the bulletin and so forth. So we'll ask the Lord, and especially ask His Mother, to help us have a holy, blessed year, a year of faith and grace. We can grow accordingly, and we won't regret it. The closer we go to the Lord, the better off we'll be. And we might inspire other people if we're living accordingly.
Celebrating a new year.
we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those who have died, especially Dave Ayers, Father Al Krupp, and Margaret Formica, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the souls of our faithful departed, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, through the prayers of your people, gathered to honor the Most Holy Mother, your Son, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
All right.
this thee, grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, send your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever.
Jesus.